The next credit in site selection and planning is about light pollution. In this recording, we will discuss credit 8, outdoor light pollution reduction. It's not much discussed compared to water pollution, air pollution, soil pollution, or ozone depletion, global warming, etc. So first, let us understand what is light pollution and why it is important. So what is light pollution? Light pollution is excessive, intrusive, artificial light in the night. Light pollution is excessive or intrusive, artificial light in night time. That is called as light pollution. So why it is important? Why we have to reduce light pollution? First, excess light comes at a cost of energy. So energy consumption means it's environmental pollution. We are burning a lot of fossil fuel and it results in environmental pollution. So light pollution, so excess light comes at a cost of energy, so it has to be reduced. And second, very important, excess night light disrupts nocturnal ecosystem. Nocturnal ecosystem means nighttime environment. It's nighttime environment. So light pollution disturbs the nocturnal ecosystem. So when the nocturnal ecosystem or nighttime environment is disturbed, it affects the entire habitat on the planet. On humans, light pollution causes sleep deprivation and hence it impacts the health. The intent or objective of this credit is to reduce light pollution so as to increase night sky access and enhance nocturnal environment. Nocturnal environment means nighttime environment. Let us look at the compliance. There are three parameters to be taken care to reduce light pollution. Number one, reduced lighting power density. LPD means lighting power density. Number two, reduced upward lighting. And number three, reduced light response. We will discuss each of them now. Number one, to reduce the light pollution, you have to reduce the lighting power density. Lighting power density is often abbreviated as LPD. Lighting power density or LPD is the ratio between total electrical power input for the luminaire installed in the space divided by the area of the space. The total electrical power is measured in watt and the area can be measured in square meter or square feet. Luminaire is nothing but lighting fixture. Here is an example for calculation of lighting power density for a project. Let us look at one particular space in this project. Let us consider parking 1. Parking 1 has an area of 32,000 square feet. It has 14 lighting fixtures, each of 250 watt. So total electrical power is, that is 250 into 14, that is equal to 3500 watt. And the area is 32,000 square feet. So the lighting power density is 3500 divided by 32,000, that is around 0.11 is the lighting power density for parking 1. To reduce the light pollution, the lighting power density should be minimum. The compliance requirement for this credit is that the lighting power density should be 30% less than the value prescribed by ASHRAE 90.1-2010. ASHRAE 90.1-2010 table 9.4.3 gives the lighting power allowance for exterior spaces. So lighting power density for the project should be 30% less than the allowance prescribed in the ASHRAE 90.1-2010 standard. The next parameter is upward lighting. Upward lighting is a lighting which goes above 90 degrees from the nadir. What is nadir? Nadir is a perpendicular line from the lighting fixture. Perpendicular line to the ground from the lighting fixture. This is the 90 degrees from nadir. So the light should be within the nadir. The light should not go beyond this red color line. So this is a good lighting. This lighting is not accepted because it goes 360 degrees. this lighting, maybe it is around 160 degrees, it is not accepted. This is okay, this is not going beyond 90 degrees, so it is okay. And this is the best actually, this is the best because it is very much less than 90 degrees from the nadir. The objective of exterior lighting is to light the ground, not the sky. So the light should not go towards the sky, that is the objective here. The light should be towards the ground only. So this is the requirement for reduced upward lighting. Next comes light trespass. So the project should reduce the light trespass. What is light trespass? Light trespass is excess lighting going beyond the property boundary. You are allowed to illuminate only your property, not your neighbor's property. So it is very important you restrict the light within your property boundary. If the light goes beyond your property boundary, that is called as light trespass. Light trespass is undesirable and it causes light pollution. Allowable light trespass limit depends on the lighting zone of the project location. If the project location is in a commercial area in the city, then the project comes under lighting zone 4. If the project area lies in a forest area, then it comes under lighting zone 1. Higher the lighting zone number, more is the light trespass limit. For instance, lighting zone 1 has very stringent light trespass limit and lighting zone 4 has the highest light trespass limit. I am putting forward few questions in light pollution to assess your understanding in this credit. Please answer them in the comment section. Question number 1. Lighting power density is measured in dash, meaning what is the unit of lighting power density? Question number two, maximum allowable lighting power density is stipulated in dash standard, which standard? Question number three, which of the following lighting zones have stringent light trespass and upward lighting allowance? We have four options, LZ1 to LZ4. Please answer these questions in the comments section. Thank you very much. Thanks for your attention.